Well, greetings, everyone. I just want to welcome all the visitors. There's many that I do know, some I don't. But just want to say greetings in Jesus' name and thank everyone for coming out, and the choir for coming, and the other visitors. Just a quick order of what will happen this evening. When I take my seat, we'll have roughly 20, 25 minutes of song, and then an intermission where Taylor will lead three songs in congregational singing. And then the remainder of the choir. And at the end, choir just stays up here, and Daryl Hirschberger will close the service. And at the end, there is refreshments and snacks in the basement, which I'm sure everyone is welcome to partake of. So that would be the start of the service this evening. And I'll just have a short prayer before I take my seat. Dear Father, we come to you this evening and just say thank you for this time together. Father, we pray for the song service. We pray for the choir. Lord, we lift them to you and just pray for the worship and song. Father, we pray your blessing upon this evening and everyone here. We lift this to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Okay. Good evening to everyone. It's a blessing to be here. There's a few familiar faces. I see my dad and mom are here. Is it Hoover? There's a few familiar faces, but there's some that we don't know as well. Our desire this evening would be to be a blessing. The Bible says, come before his presence with thanksgiving and worship him. And Jesus said, they that worship him must worship him in truth and spirit. That is whom he seeks to worship him. And that will be our heart this evening to do that. And I pray that you can do the same. Pray for us as we endeavor to sing some songs. And I'm not so sure that we have a specific theme. One thing you will hear a fair amount of is about the stars and his creation. And there's a few of those songs. Listen closely as we sing them. And it's one thing. A brother today had a opening, a devotional, whatever, on the Word of God as it's safe to follow like a compass. And I was thinking about that. He was talking about the star, to follow the stars they did in the old days. But I thought about this as well. There's only one star that's safe to follow and look to. Like literally the North Star. Everything else rotates. But that is always there. And thus it is with Christ, with God our Father, with his word. That's safe to follow. It will always be there. So Lord bless you this evening. second verse there, it said, soon as the evening shades prevail, like a curtain comes across the sky, and the moon takes up the wondrous tale, and nightly to the listening earth repeats the story of her birth, whilst all the stars that round her burn, and all the planets in their turn, confirm the tidings as they roll, and spread the truth from pole to pole. What though, in solemn silence, all move round the dark terrestrial ball? What though no real voice nor sound amidst their radiant orbs be found? That's a question mark. But in reason's ear, they all rejoice and utter forth a glorious voice, forever singing as they shine, the hand that made them, made us, is divine. This daughter, this afternoon, I was sitting outside with my little daughter, and the sun was shining. We're sitting on the south side of a building, and it was very warm, and I asked them, I told them, let's be quiet and see if we can hear the sun making noise. The one's a little older. She said, he doesn't make any noise. But the younger one, excuse me, but she said, well, I'd like to go up there and sing with him. And the older one said, it's too far away. The younger one said, well, maybe he could make a hole up there and I could take a big ladder and I could get in. Little innocent hearts, they can sing. Sometimes us as older, we have all the reason and knowledge and we, whatever. Sometimes we can't sing very well. But God desires worship in our hearts. And if they said when they was leading Jesus to the hill of Golgotha, or no, I'm sorry, the triumphal entry, they said, if the people don't say Hosanna, the rocks will cry out. And if we won't praise him, the stars and the moon and his glory will forever do that. And it's doing it. Though there's no real voice, yet there is. So I was blessed by that thought.
Christ the truth, the all. This next song we're going to sing once again speaks of the stars and the glory of God in creation. The first verse says, "The stars declare his glory. The vault of heaven springs, mute witness of the Master's hand in all created things. And through the silences of space, their soundless music sings." Goes along well with what Brother Merv shared there about the soundless music in space. And as we think of God in all of the creation, all the amazing things that we see, the stars and just the vastness of some of those things, we can't comprehend it. And then there's Earth, just this small little speck inside of this, what we call space, and it has a solar system. And on that Earth somewhere is me and you. And God, in all of his power and his amazing creation, he chose to make man in his image on this small little earth, and he calls us the apple of his eye, and yet man has turned his back on him. So he sent his son to die on the cross that we can be saved from our sins, that we can live above sin, and that we can one day see him, and yet still man has turned their back on him for the most part. And so my desire is that we could understand God as an almighty God who created all these amazing things, and yet he wants to dwell within the hearts of us as humans. God bless.
The verse of this hymn that stands out to me, a prayer, verse 4 says, "So order to this life of mine, direct it all my days. The meditations of my heart be innocence and praise." And that phrase, "the meditations of my heart be innocence and praise," is a beautiful prayer.
Looks like I've got a sizable car of my own to direct. Turn to number 266 in the Hymns of the Church. Number 266.
Thank you.
number 259. Across the page to number 260. Number 260.
Hark the choirs of angels' voices, joyful hearts. Well, good evening to each one of you. This next song that we're going to sing is entitled The Wayside Cross, and it paints a picture of a pilgrim in need of direction and guidance and just light on him for the path that he should take. And I was thinking, you know, we often find ourselves at a place in our life at crossroads. We have a choice before us that we have to make, and I was just thinking, you know, perhaps you're here tonight and you have to choose whether you're going to continue to enjoy the pleasures of sin or whether you're going to surrender your life to Christ. Or maybe you have chosen to follow Christ and you have to choose whether you're going to forgive your brother that wronged you last week or month, or whether you're going to forgive him. Or perhaps, you know, perhaps you find yourself going through a trial or a difficulty in your life, and you have to choose whether you're going to continue to let the Lord just work his will out in your life or and trust him in that way, or whether you're going to become bitter through the difficulties that you face and just walk away from the Lord. You know, I don't know any of you in here tonight, but my encouragement is that you know, if you find yourself in a place in life where you need direction for your path and you don't know which way to turn, just look to the Lord and he will be there to show us the way and to lead us home. God bless each one of you.
Jesus has died to redeem you from This next song we're going to sing is titled, My God, How Endless Is Thy Love. I'm just going to read the first two lines. It says, My God, how endless is thy love. Thy gifts are every evening new, and morning mercies from above, gently distill like early dew. Thou spreadst the curtain of the night, great guardian of my sleeping hours. Thy sovereign word restores the light and quickens all my drowsy powers. That title, My God, How Endless Is Thy Love, as it says, his mercies are new every evening and every morning. And I was thinking, God has invested a lot into humanity and at times we can get discouraged in this life. And if we just think back of all that God has done for us and his love in coming to this earth for wretched man to die, we can praise him. The last part of this song says, perpetual blessings, with perpetual there means ongoing blessings from thy hand demands perpetual or ongoing songs of praise. His love to us demands a response, and that is songs of praise.
Hey, good evening. This next song we're going to sing, it's called Whom Will You Serve? It's been one of my favorite songs for the past couple years. It's a very powerful song. The first verse kind of goes in the lines of an unconverted state of mind. The second verse is more of the converted state of mind. It leaves us with a question, who will we serve? We all know that Matthew 6:24, it says, no man can serve two masters, for either he would hate the one and love the other, or else he would hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. Each one of us were created into this world. God has put us into this world with a purpose. And he gave each one of us a free choice in life to make, a choice that will determine our destiny. So it's really up to each one of us. I encourage each one to examine our own lives tonight. Tomorrow is too late. Let's examine our lives and see if we are really serving the true God or if we let other things come into our lives. May God bless you.
This next song we're singing is One Piece Like a River, which I'm sure most of you know this song. But we switched out the third verse, or another verse that has really blessed me since I've learned it. It says, "But Lord, 'tis for thee, for thy coming we wait. The sky, not the grave, is our goal. O trump of the angel, O voice of the Lord, blessed hope, blessed rest of my soul." And I just think it's, we should be excited that we don't have to live this life and just, oh, we do something good here and we have an exciting part here, and but it all ends in the grave. No, if we are surrendered to Christ, we can go up to the sky and be in heaven with God and Jesus and all the other saints.
And real estate investor who lost a fortune in the Great Chicago Fire of 1871. Around that same time, his beloved 4-year-old son died of scarlet fever. So, thinking a vacation might do his family some good, he sent his wife Anna and 4 daughters on a ship bound to Paris, planning to join them after he had finished some pressing duties at home. But, however, while on the ship named the Ville du Havre, while crossing the Atlantic Ocean at about 2:00 in the morning, passengers were jolted awake from their slumber. Despite the clear, starry sky, the Ville du Havre inexplicably collided with the Loch Earn, an iron-hulled Scottish clipper. Lifeboats quickly filled with people. Many passengers leapt into the icy waters. Anna tried desperately to keep her children together, but in the confusion, they all became separated. More than 200 people lost their lives, including the 4 Spafford daughters. But later, Anna was found unconscious but alive, floating on a wooden plank. When the ship docked in Wales, Anna sent a telegram to her husband. It read, "Saved alone, what shall I do?" Horatio immediately set sail from New York. He wrote to a friend, "There is just one thing that has become magnificently clear. I must not lose faith."
No Satan should buffet the trial.
Days into his voyage, the captain of the ship summoned Mr. Spafford to the foredeck. By their calculations, they were near the very place where the Ville du Havre had gone down, taking with it Horatio's 4 daughters, now resting some 3 miles below. But Horatio refused to look down. Instead, he gazed out across the rolling waves and up into the moonlit sky, and it was there and then that he began to formulate a simple expression of his faith, with words that would later become a well-beloved hymn.
It is well. It is well.
With my soul.
With my soul. It is well. It is well.
power to rise above tragedy. Whenever and however we suffer our own night of sorrow, God's love can and does shine in the darkness. Hope can heal the wounded soul. And with that blessed hope of heaven as our goal, we can join with saints and with angels singing, it is well with my soul.
To everyone here tonight, this evening, I guess, is somewhat of an ending here. This evening, I just thought I'd take a few minutes to share, and it's the last performance that we're planning to do here. We spend a few months working to try to learn these songs, and we tried to get those things right, and the next song that we want to sing talks about another ending. It talks about the ending of our life, and it talks about soaring on wings through the starlit sky back to our heavenly home. And if we think about that moment when there's a trump of God that we sang about, it's going to sound, and the heavens are going to split wide open. And are we going to soar with wings through the starlit sky to our heavenly home? That's my heart, my desire. I believe it's all of our desires here. Or are we going to, it talks about leaving behind all the troubles and the strife of this life and all the things that that we face here at times. Are we going to be willing to do that, or are we holding on to the things of this life tonight? So I just want to encourage you to turn your hearts to the Lord, each one. God bless you.
Soaring on wings through the starless sky.
next song we sing has been a favorite of mine. It talks about the kingdoms of earth and how they pass away. They rise, they fall. The kingdoms of earth pass away, but the kingdom of heaven remains. And it has always blessed me as I sing that song. There's many unsureties in life. There's many things we don't know about. There's many fears we may have, but we don't need to fear this kingdom. If we're a part of this kingdom, it will always remain. The only question we need to ask ourselves is, am I part of this kingdom? The kingdom of heaven will remain. The song talks about the hurricanes roar, the enemy tries to throw things against it, but it remains sure. And the question is, am I a part of it? Are you a part of it?
Songs. This last song is kind of it's called Donkey Sean. How many understand that? At least some of you do. It's a little bit German. It's a thank you song. And it says, please give to us our daily bread. Our Lord taught us to pray. By Jesus' hands we all are fed, and you are his hands today. Blessed are his hands incarnate. Thank you for your love. With gracious care, our needs were met, reflections from above. And so we thank you. And so we thank you, God's grace and peace be with you. May God's grace and peace be with you. That'd be our prayer this evening. So we'll do this one and one more, and then we're finished.
Please give to us our daily bread, our Lord.
Well, thank you to you as a chorus for coming and sharing tonight. It was a blessing to be here. You did lead us in worship of our great Creator. I enjoyed all the songs, but there were a few that really grabbed my attention. The first one was the last one before the intermission. It's such a powerful song of calling us to personal accountability before God and just laying out those choices of life and then the consequences. And then you tie that in with the song Soaring on Wings. Heaven awaiting us, the hope of the Christian. So thank you for sharing tonight. It's been many years since I've helped sing on a chorus, but I remember all the hard work that goes into it. But you know, I'm always impressed with the fact that even you can have a chorus or a group that sings every note just pitch perfect, but if there's not a relationship with the one that you're singing about, it doesn't transmit the message as well. So the Lord bless you as you share in this way and build up His kingdom. Thank you to all of you for coming out tonight. It's good to see the house filled up. And please, all of you, stay here. We dug deep into our pantries, and so we should have enough snacks for all of you. And if not, we'll just have some good fellowship anyhow. So I'll have a closing prayer, and then you can just find your way downstairs, and we'll serve you what we have. Let's all stand for a closing prayer. Father God, we just pause before you to thank you again for your many blessings to us. Father, we've been reminded of so many things tonight, from the vast extent of your creation and the wonders of that to the wonders of our salvation. Father, that is the greatest of all, and the fact that we can have eternal life. We do have eternal life in you. Father, thank you for each one on this chorus, their director, the families that support them, the church that is behind them. We pray your blessing upon them. We pray that you grant them safety as they travel back home again tonight. Lord, we also thank you for the snacks that we will have tonight, and we pray that the fellowship would be a blessing to each other and to you. Father, would you go with us as we go from here? We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. You are dismissed.